In this video, we're going to discuss domain and range of a function. Domain, by definition, is all the set of inputs which yield an output. And range is that set of corresponding outputs. So in looking at our function, when we want to look for the domain, we want to look across the x-axis because those are where our inputs are. And we see that they yield an output. So in looking for the range, we want to look across the y-axis to determine what our range is. Now we need a way of notating this. So let's start with domain. So we've seen that we want to look across the x-axis and that our domain goes from negative 5 to 6. It includes negative 5 because of the closed circle, but does not include 6 because of the open circle. Writing that in interval notation gives us negative 5 to 6, a bracket on the negative 5, and a parenthesis on the 6. So in domain, we're looking across the x values. This can also be written with inequalities. We could say x is greater than or equal to negative 5 and less than 6. Those are equivalent ways of writing the domain. Now we'll do the range, which are all the possible outputs. Notice the endpoints are included, but those aren't the same endpoints of our range. Our range goes from our minimum value to our maximum value, which in this case is negative 3 to 4, and both of those are included, so both get brackets. Once again, we can write this in interval notation, and we get that y is in between negative 3 and 4, both with less than or equal to signs, because we can get negative 3 as an output, and we can get 4 as an output. That means we want to include them.